The first screen of Neighborhood Map Machine is the title screen. This shows the title, the people who designed the program, the year the version was produced, and the option of having the language in Spanish or English.
The next screen is where you choose what modes you want to play, such as creating your own map, explore a map, solve a mystery, do activities, continue an old map, or print out a 3D version of something.
By choosing to create your own map, you will first have to decide what size map you want. Then you can insert things such as highways and other types of roads by clicking on the one you want and dragging it onto the grid space. Houses and other buildings, trees, traffic signals, animals and people, water and grass for a park can be inserted as well.
In each mode, there is a key that lets you see what each object on the grid is. By clicking on the word, it can be read aloud to you. There is also a ruler that can be used to measure distances. Just click and drag where you want measured, and the inches measured will be figured and then translated into what that represents in feet.
The paint palette tool can be used to draw your own figures in, highlight something of importance, put in text, or erase something you have drawn or highlighted.
The notes part of the program is available in every mode as well. It allows you to write in notes or make questions for others. They can be typed in or made by speaking into a microphone. When you're done creating, you can save by clicking the Done button, which takes you back to the screen where you choose your mode.
By clicking Explore, there are many different places you can choose from. Each one starts by giving you some instructions in the notepad that can be read out loud to you by clicking the Play Sound button. Use the compass by clicking the arrow of the direction you want to go to move the red arrow around the map. The paint palette is also available in this activity, just as in the last one. You can also see how far you have traveled in the miles bar. Clicking on it will have it read out loud to you. The yellow button resets the miles bar.
The key and notepad are still available in this mode as well. The Solve a Mystery mode also gives you several different mysteries to choose from. The first clue will pop up and be read to you. Follow the clue to the next clue by moving your red arrow with the compass directional arrows.
Again, the feet bar is there to show you how far you have traveled so you can get as close to your clue as possible. After finding the next clue, click the See Clue button for the next clue to be read to you. Continue following the clues until you find the last clue. If you happen to go to a place where there is no clue, the program will tell you that there is no clue, so continue looking for the next clue. When you think you have found the last clue, click Guess to make a prediction of where the missing object is. If you are correct, a screen of congratulations will appear and cheering noises will be heard. The Activities mode of Neighborhood Map Machine allows you to do certain activities as social studies, math, and language arts. In social studies, you can choose from symbols, direction, scale and distance, using grid coordinates, perspective, place, movement, interaction, and economics. In language arts, you can choose from writing directions, creative writing, descriptive writing, persuasive writing, vocabulary, settings and literature, reading directions, and phonics. In math, you can choose from addition and subtraction, fraction and decimals, multiplication and division, multi-step, estimation, measurement, patterns, and geometry. In each mode, it allows you to do a mystery, create mode, or even explore. In each one of these, it is just like every other mode that we have already explored. It allows you to view miles, use the paint palette, notes, and keys are all available. From the selection screen, you can also open an old map that you have previously saved. And you can print goodies, such as 3D pop-ups or cutouts, map machine logo, or even grids. Neighborhood Map Machine can be used in the classroom in place of worksheets and homework because students can interact with one another or do activities by themselves. It helps each student get involved in solving the problems and making the questions for each map. It gives students another option to learning certain material or material they have previously learned. It is a good tool because it doesn't just explore one topic, but several topics. The relative advantage of this software is that it makes these subjects more appealing to students by getting them involved using graphics, and it speaks to kids in an appealing voice. The problem the software is solving is that sometimes students may not understand the information the way the teacher explained it, so then teachers can use this program as an alternate means of teaching that information.